गुड मॉर्निंग, नमस्कार। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट एग्जामिनेशन ऑफ हिप जॉइंट पार्ट टू। इन प्रीवियस वीडियो यू सी डिफरेंट एबनॉर्मलिटीज एंड प्रोसेस फॉर एग्जामिनेशन एंड इवेल्युएशन ऑफ साइन एंड सिम्टम्स रिलेटेड विथ hip joints. So today we start from physical examination in lying down position. Physical examination in lying down position. So in routine examination, number one is palpation is the method of choice. Palpation is the method of choice. Feel the local rise of temperature. Elicit and evaluate tenderness. Feel and palpate for bony, hard or soft mass in various location. Look for lumbar lordosis and levels of AI, SIS. Feel for femoral artery pulsation. If not felt, vascular sign of north is said to be positive. What is this? This is a test to elicit the presence of head of the femur. Procedure: patient in supine position, palpate the femoral artery, pulse bilaterally for volume, intensity and position. Findings are normally volume, intensity and position of the femoral artery pulse are palpable bilaterally. In case of hip dislocation, head of the femur displaced from its position and femoral artery lost its bony support, so there will be great difficulty in filling femoral artery. Positive test: if the femoral pulses are not palpable, indication of hip dislocation. In case of hip dislocation, femoral pulses are not palpable. If the femoral pulse are feeble, fracture neck of femur. In case of fracture neck of femur, femoral pulses are feeble. Deformity examination. What are the different deformities in hip joint and lower extremities? Fixed flexion deformity, fixed abduction deformity, and fixed rotational deformity. Fixed abduction deformity and fixed rotational deformity. Measurement of length. In this diagram, you see measurement of length, and length vary according to a standing position or due to any abnormality in lower extremities. Examination of the movement of the hip joint. Movements by hip joint maintain flexion, extension, abduction, adduction, internal rotation and external rotation. This is normally, and it varies up to certain degree or angle, but if it decreased, then abnormal conditions related to stiffness of joints or muscle wasting or any other causes are present. Test for hip stability in standing position and in lying position. This is diagram of Trendelenburg test in a standing position. This shows the stability of the hip joint. Other test, measurement of muscle wasting. If loss of muscles or circular measurement of both thigh differ, then we think about the muscles wasting. In this way, we see the different abnormalities in relation with the hip joint and examination of hip joint in clinical examination in orthopedic, maybe or other technique or examination or evaluating process required for diagnosis. This depends upon age, sex, and including occupation and abnormalities or sign and symptoms present in individual person. So I conclude examination of the hip joint in orthopedic. If any doubt have you send me in chat box or by email. Thank you for watching. Like, share and subscribe.